The following exercises are suitable for these prosthetic knee joints. Apart from that, always consider the user's physical condition. The knee joint bends slightly during initial contact and loading response when observing physiological gait. This movement serves as a shock absorber, relieves the musculoskeletal system, and provides safety through a faster foot flat position. Step by step, Franziska and Gerhard develop the sections of stance phase and the transition to swing phase. Gerhard learns to allow knee flexion and to shift his center of mass over the prosthetic foot. This pattern causes knee and hip extension in terminal stance and is a basic prerequisite for stance release. Franziska guides the pelvis during the weight shift onto the prosthesis. The trunk and the pelvis simultaneously move forward. A hyperlordosis should be avoided. While the flexion of the knee during this exercise may appear exaggerated or unnatural looking, developing stance phase knee flexion at slow speeds is a basic requirement for a secure and natural gait. Furthermore, it will help Gerhard when walking down hills later on. Gerhard tries to use the motion sequence during consecutive steps. It requires time and training to integrate this natural knee flexion. Consciously walking with stance flexion should be trained over and over again. Especially train this movement when walking outside of the parallel bars and during outdoor training. Due to the embedded sensors in the knee joint, backwards walking is detected. Stance release is disabled during backward steps. Franziska shows Gerhard an additional functional possibility of the knee joint. Gerhard can use the hydraulic stance flexion resistance while walking backwards to yield into knee flexion. Franziska slightly holds the prosthetic foot down to encourage knee flexion.